guys. Okay, so I keep two trimmer heads in the truck. I keep this one, which has heavy duty 105 black diamond, and then I keep the main trimmer head, which is what I use most of the time, the regular steel trimmer head, which is a steel too. This is the auto cut C26-2. This is the whatever comes standard with the FS94R. And I have the line I have on here, this clear stuff, is from Home Depot. I've been using that, and it's the picture that I have in the video. It's the Pro something or other. They just started carrying that, so I've been liking that pretty good. Here's the 105 Black Diamond, and the reason I use this on this spool is because we're about to get into the backyard, and I know that the grass is going to be thicker than it was here in the front. So I think the trimmer is going to be strong enough to cut that, but you have to meet it halfway in the middle. You have to give it some help. So we're going to go with this head, and then we're going to go with the 105 Black Diamond, because the Black Diamond is so razor sharp, and it doesn't do that well on edging and the ground and against hard surfaces. It'll get eaten up by the fence a little bit and the swing set back there and the other objects, but the majority it's going to be hitting is the grass, and it's going to be tearing that up, slicing it and kicking it out. And I'm angling myself so the cut part of the grass, as it rotates inside of that shield area, remember you have an outlet where everything's coming out. So if you're too perpendicular to the fence, it's going to kick the cut grass right back to the fence, and you don't want to do that. So you open yourself out a little bit, so the grass, as it's getting cut, it cuts out and it gets discharged into the grass where the mower can pick it up, or you can rake it up, or whatever you want to do with it. So we're going to go ahead and put some of this line on here, then we're going to get back to cutting. Thank you. Okay guys, found the longest runner in the world. Check this out. Yeah. Right there.
Thank you.
So we got this yard trimmed down with the trimmer, so we're about to grab the mower. I'm going to go ahead and do the best we can. We're going to set the setting up. However, I do need gas for my push mower. I forgot to get that. So we're going to run to the gas station real quick, fill up our 2-gallon tank, and this should be it. We'll have plenty of daylight to finish everything up. The gas station is at the end of the subdivision, so we'll be right back. Okay guys, so we're all finished up. Probably wondering what am I wearing. These glasses are my evening time glasses. When it gets about 6 o'clock or so, 5-6 o'clock, and the sun starts setting, it brightens everything up and I'm able to see a little bit better. But anyway, so we're done here with this property. You guys might not be able to see me because of that shadow. But anyways, these are my evening time glasses. So we're all done here. It really didn't take that long to do. Looks like that Cub Cadet has bit the bullet. It's a goner. So you know, it actually turned out pretty good. We only had about three and a half bags on the push mower. So did pretty well. Got it cleaned up, and you know, we got $100 for this yard. I told him 75, but he left an extra 25, so that was pretty nice of him. Now, you know, we don't pick up trash, so all we did was did the best we can, blowing that grass off, and so we got that taken care of for him. So, but everything else turned out, you know, pretty good. So let's go ahead and go to the front. Now, it's still kind of the cooler part of the year, so the grass isn't going to grow super fast. I don't know if I'm going to pick them up as regular property because I don't want to be using my push mower all the time. You know. Got that guy. Alright, here we go. So, you know, and I'm, you know, I don't really want to do push mower. You see, that's all that can get through here. You know, I want to be on my big mower, you know, knocking properties out quickly. You know, if I had to push this one, I'd have to sell $50. I know he's not going to want to do that, and I don't want to do it even $50. So let's see here. All right, so we got everything cleaned up, man. Looks good. You know, again, we don't pick up trash. We're not a trash company. I'll leave your trash right where I see it. I don't care. You know, unless it's agreed in the price or agreed of, you know, what we're doing, I don't pick up trash. All right, so we got the flower bed. I didn't clean anything out. I just hit it with a trimmer, which is all we discussed. Kind of gave the edge back much as we can. Same thing over here. You know, it's not one of those yards that's super impressive after it's clean because it's been neglected a lot. And so what we're going to do is we are done with this property. So we're going to go ahead and go home, shower up, get the equipment off. And then we got an estimate tomorrow and a property to mow and some flower bed stuff to do all in one property. So after that, we'll be done for the day. We'll wash the truck, vacuum it out. We'll do some equipment maintenance, change last year's oil out. But anyways, if you guys have any questions about this video, drop them in the section down below. Let me know. Again, you know, I asked for 75 on this. I was here maybe at the most 2 hours, and I know I should have charged more than that, but I really wanted to do the video, and the guy gave me $100. So, you know, that's bonus right there. Anyways, guys, I'm Kevin with Texas Veteran Power Outdoors. See you next time.